it's hopeful. There is there a breakthrough?
That was the worst of humanity. That I found out, yes, it's true, and it's massively profound, and people didn't know about it.
Difference, right? So it's like sometimes timing for an author makes a big difference.
Yeah, nothing.
And then you caught it yourself.
This is what happens if you delay a book.
It takes a long time. It's incredibly detailed. Mm. But what I appreciated about it is it's not boring.
There is, and how it interacts or doesn't interact, as the brakes were on the whole time.
Were there places in the world where either doctors or even just naturally people were able to do this?
Right. That's one of what has made this story especially. What's in their guts, the little bugs that we're learning determine so much about who we are. 1,000 people or something around that number. Ones that are the most mutated, you could say the ugliest, but they look the most different. Go on and you can see, whoa, that's really a different type of cell.
Debate over the past 10 years.
Absolutely.
I mean, they said, for example, they said that Christopher Reeve was going to walk again next week if we allowed stem cell therapies.
Not a shallower dive, but perhaps something than most people until he gets it. And then suddenly has to deal with it. And he confronted him later and said, and said basically there was just nothing left to build for.
Let's talk about you as an author. So did you study journalism or did you just fall into writing?
Oh, no. No.
He's actually not written the book, but he has all these anecdotes and stories and things that he's been able to pull together as well.
So now, and there are archives, right? So now you're in the archives of New York Hospital and the Rockefeller Foundation because it involves the Rockefellers. And you can find the most fascinating things about, late 19th century medicine and Lister and sanitation and all these other topics that won't necessarily get you down the road, but the primary source material, clearly, or was I now just fluent in the language enough to sound like I knew what I was talking about and to have a conversation with perhaps the wrong people and fool them? I could pass tests, but I wasn't necessarily talking to a reader. So I had to understand it.
Well, so that you could then put it in your language.
That's right.
Where you're writing. Like, did you put these things up on the walls?
Yes. So I word pictures in a way. That it's a way of footnotes or shorthand, if you will. Then there are stacks of papers everywhere. There are things tacked to the wall. I had wonderful pictures of all the people that were involved and not involved. So that sort of repetition can be a little ugly from a writing standpoint, but from a reading standpoint, it makes it much more comprehensive. It doesn't work for everybody. I need to make sure that it had that that heart to it and that my heart was in it.
I think it did. When you write, do you write in silence or do you have music playing?
It's very complicated. I needed to remove all distractions for this
one. Where do you see this going next for you? So you've done two big projects. I know you write a lot along the way.